Happy picture day, everybody. Smile like you mean it. Go ahead and sit down there. One, two. Did you want to smile?
This is my genuine smile.
Okay. All right, next. Show me them pearly whites.
Oh, wow. You're showing all of them whites. Okay.
Next, come on in. Oh, I see you need a second to get ready. Okay. All right, let's do this. Show me what you're working with.
Oof.
All right, come on in. Give me anything.
Is this okay? This is harder than I thought.
All right, next.
I hate picture day.
Whenever you're ready. Is that ready? Last one, come on in. This is the smile I've been waiting for.
Hey everyone, it's Katrina, and I hope you all enjoyed and didn't cringe too much at that little skit. Today I'm here with a video that I've been thinking about for over 4 years, and I'm finally deciding to just push past my fear and anxiety and hesitations, and I'm just gonna do it. This video is about my tips on how to smile more genuinely in photos. You might find yourself throughout this video thinking, okay, this stuff Katrina is saying sounds a little bit out there and it's making me uncomfortable. I don't think I can do that. But I implore you, since you're already here with me, just lean into it. Smiling is so important, and it can help elevate our moods, it can help lower our stress levels, it can help lower our blood pressure, boost our immune system, and studies have shown correlations between those who smiled more, they lived longer, they got married more, they got divorced less. And of course, I'm not saying to smile 24/7. I certainly don't do that, but if you are looking to live a healthier, better lifestyle, don't forget about the smile and work on the muscles in your face as you're also working on like building the other muscles in your body too. So I'm gonna get started with just some background on the different kind of smiles, and then I'll go into my tips. So today we'll be talking about the Duchenne smile, or the genuine smile, versus the non-Duchenne smile, or the social or polite smile. And the name Duchenne is named after a French neurologist slash anatomist in the 1800s, and he did a lot of problematic and really unethical studies, but he was looking at facial expressions, and he looked at the muscles that move when people feel pure joy and are producing a genuine smile. A Duchenne smile is one that we naturally produce when we're feeling enjoyment, and it's involuntary. So it's an automatic smile that we do when we're happy, when we're laughing, and it involves two muscles in our faces. So I'm gonna lift my glasses up here. So the first one is the zygomatic major muscle, which is at the corner of our mouth, and when that contracts, it pulls our mouth up. But the smile is not just about the mouth. The other muscle that's working is the orbicularis oculi muscle, and that is going to pull your cheeks and the corner of your eyes as it contracts to make the genuine smile. So it's both those two muscles working together that produces a Duchenne smile. So a non-Duchenne or social or polite smile is one that you probably do all the time when you're walking down the street and you make eye contact with a stranger and you just, right? You just kind of curl the corners of your mouth up so that they don't think you're mean or rude. And so when we do that, just like a simple, that is a non-Duchenne smile, and that just involves the mouth. It could also look like this. And that's how I used to smile a lot in middle school, because I thought it was just all about the mouth. So I would just open my mouth and not move my eyes. Before, it was thought that the Duchenne smile was involuntary, an automatic thing that only happens when we're feeling pure joy and we can't just reproduce it. But people are now moving towards the thought that it's not just emotions that cause facial expressions. Facial expressions can actually lead to different emotions. So if we're smiling more and more, we're more likely to feel joy. So the question is, how do we get ourselves to smile a Duchenne smile, right? It's not just about squinting our eyes, it's not just about pulling our mouths open, but the good news is we've all already done it so many times in our lives. Whenever we're feeling happy, whenever we're laughing, or we're feeling joy, we produce Duchenne smile after Duchenne smile. And so the trick is to just be conscious about it and to practice it to the point where it becomes muscle memory and you're able to produce it on cue, especially in an awkward and inauthentic situation like picture day. So I get that not everybody wants to smile genuinely in taking photos, right? Maybe some people don't want their eyes looking too small, or they want to look a bit cooler or more serious. A little smirk is enough for them. Whatever the reason is, it's totally cool. It's your photo, it's your smile. But if you are looking to smile more genuinely in photos and you want some tips, I have some coming up, but this is the part where you really just have to lean into it and just give it a shot. My first tip is to smile and laugh at yourself when you're in front of a mirror. Now, it doesn't need to be a dedicated time where you're standing in the mirror, but whenever you are in front of the mirror, whether it's brushing your teeth, combing your hair, doing your skincare, getting ready for the day, give yourself a smile or just make yourself laugh. And if you feel like, how in the world am I gonna just produce a smile? Like, I can't do that. Maybe just think about, I can't believe I watched Katrina's video on how to smile and now I'm here in front of the mirror considering whether or not I should smile. And if you think that to yourself, you might feel silly enough to crack a smile. If not, just think of something that makes you happy, wave hi to yourself, do things so that you can smile, see how it looks, and then feel the muscles moving in your face. And just do it again and again. And I know it might feel silly and really embarrassing to smile at yourself and laugh at yourself in front of the mirror, but trust me, no one will know. So just do it for yourself. Maybe you already know how to smile perfectly well and naturally, just give yourself a smile in front of the mirror. It's so funny, I was standing in front of the mirror today and then my mom came in and was like, I told you to smile in the mirror when you were a kid, and I have no memory of that, but it's a good thing that she did because I do it all the time now.
That's what your mom told you, you smile in the mirror.
I have no memory of that, but good thing you did that, mom.
Yeah.
Do you do that?
Yeah.
Do you do that right now?
I already used to myself.
Still, you gotta give yourself a smile.
So my second tip is similar. Maybe you don't want to be in the restroom all the time or in front of a mirror, but you have your phone with you. So my tip is to just turn your phone camera on, hit record, and just do the same thing. Make yourself laugh, make yourself smile, and then look back at it to see how you look before and how you look producing that smile and afterwards. I think this is more effective than just taking selfies because I find that when I'm taking selfies, my smile is always a little bit less natural and I feel like there's a lot of pressure in hitting it at the exact right time. So when you're recording, you just hit it once and then you just let yourself naturally smile. So this next tip is to look through the photos that you already have of yourself, whether it's childhood photos, teenage photos, or photos that you've recently taken, and just evaluate the smiles. Are they a Duchenne smile? Are they a non-Duchenne smile? Is it not even a smile? I know that when I was a kid and when I was a teenager, I was experimenting a lot with my smile, and sometimes I would just pull my mouth even bigger, and then in early high school, I would squint my eyes really small, and it took me years to figure out the smile that worked for me, but it was looking through those old photos and coming home after school, taking a bunch of selfies that helped me figure out what felt more natural and what didn't. If you feel like those tips are way too weird, you don't want to spend the time doing that, then another way to just progress slowly would be to not shy away from photos and to practice smiling with teeth in photos. Now, I know a lot of people, their go-to smile is a teethless smile, but I urge you to just challenge yourself. Start smiling with teeth. Whether you feel like you have a good smile or not, just start smiling with teeth, and I promise that as you go on, you're going to feel more comfortable smiling with teeth, and you're going to just slowly start to get better at it. I have a lot of friends who it's very apparent that their smile gradually evolved as I took more and more pictures of them in high school and college. So if you don't want to do that and you want to find yourself in a more natural, authentic smiling moment, then you can just make a mental note of when it is you feel pure joy and when you know you'd be either smiling or laughing. Whether it's when you're listening to your favorite song or when you're getting off work on a Friday or you see your pet doing something silly or you're about to eat your favorite food, just make a mental note of when that's going to happen next. And when you do produce that genuine smile, just be aware of it and be aware of how your face feels so that you can reproduce that smile again. So my last tip is just to practice, practice, practice. I know it might seem weird to practice your smiling, but just like any new workout, it might feel a little bit uncomfortable, unnatural, and awkward in the beginning. But the more you do it and the more you practice, it'll just become natural and part of your routine to the point where you're able to produce it whenever you want to. One last thing, if you are practicing so much to the point where your smile starts to feel unfamiliar and foreign, just give yourself a break. I definitely felt that way in the beginning of the video when I was filming that skit. By the time I got to the last character I played, I didn't didn't even know if I knew how to smile anymore. And it's the same thing as when you say a word over and over again, or if you write a word over and over again. It's gonna feel weird, so just give yourself a break and then come back later. So those are all my tips. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and I hope that it made you smile at least once. If you found it helpful, or if you laughed, or anything like that, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment below. I want to thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Let's smile one time together before I go. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Bye, everybody.